Agent 47 and Diana Burnwood are the world's top assassins working for the ICA. Unknowingly, they have been hired by a shadow client to target a number of operatives of Providence, a secret organization working in the highest echelons of power. Providence's controller, the Constant, approaches Diana and makes her a deal. Eliminate the shadow client and learn about 47's past. But when 47 discovers that the shadow client is Lucas Gray, his lost childhood friend, he and Diana switch sides to fulfill an old pact. Destroy Providence. Together, they manage to capture the Constant, forcing him to reveal the identities of the three Providence partners. Eliminate them, and the war would be over. However, the Constant has an ace up his sleeve. Look closer. In the shadows. Behind the everyday world. Beyond the headlines and the seats of power. A hidden hand. A kind of company known as Providence. To it, we were just assets to use and throw away, to do the unthinkable, the unforgivable, and it never gave us a second thought until now. After decades in the shadows, we are fighting back. Me and 47. Much has been lost, but we are closer than ever. We trapped the Constant, Providence's chief controller, and finally learnt the names of its three partners. In their downfall, we lay the past to rest. And, just maybe, look towards the future.
47. It's time. Partners are down there. You know, I never planned this far ahead.
You never do.
I see someone got his memory back. Wait, is that a beacon? What the hell? Base. Alexa Carlisle's helicopter just took off. Confirmed target locations. Over.
Diana, what's the status?
Right. We have a situation. Carlisle has left the building. And I think I know why. The Constant has escaped. He persuaded one of the sailors into setting him free. And since then, he's been seizing control of Providence assets and resources. I can only assume Carlisle is rushing to contain the damage.
If she slips away again...
We'll keep track of her. Make sure she doesn't. Meanwhile, the plan stays the same. Your destination is the Scepter, the world's tallest building where the partners are laying low, courtesy of their host, Sheikh Omar al-Ghazali. Marcus Stuyvesant is fifth-generation old money. His family made its fortune in real estate and banking, and were at one point the chief landowners in New York. Carl Ingram is a powerful Washington kingmaker whose family grew rich selling gunpowder during the American Civil War and later established a globe-spanning empire in oil, coal, and steel. Both families long since retreated from public view, but their quiet dominance endures to this day. Now, the partners likely suspect that we're coming, so Mr. Gray will infiltrate building controls and disable all electronic doors and elevators. Stuyvesant and Ingram are about to find they have nowhere left to run.
Right. This is our moment, 47. Providence ruined our lives with the flick of a pen. Today, we return the favor. Happy hunting.
Welcome to Dubai, 47. Today is the inauguration of the scepter, and the ceremony is well underway. You will find Marcus Stuyvesant near the building's signature art installation. While a paranoid Carl Ingram has ensconced himself in his penthouse suite, security on highest alert. Mr. Gray is already in position and ready to assist. Good luck, 47.
Do you copy?
I'm here.
Are you in position?
I'm heading towards the point of entry.
Good. Get back to me when you're there. Use your camera and scan the lock, will you? I think I can override the window's controls from here.
I'm in position.
47, the inauguration is taking place close by. Once you've infiltrated it, get your bearings. I'm sure there must be floor plans somewhere.
Understood.
We need absolute focus on this one. If Ingram and Stuyvesant are alerted to our presence, we may lose them for good. We are so close, 47.
Don't worry. They're not going anywhere.
Barge Al-Ghazali.
And as all of you know, I am from one of the less privileged sides of the respectable Al-Ghazali family. But with a small loan from my father, I soon built up a construction empire that was worthy of the great Al-Ghazali legacy. So, I would like to thank my cousins, without whose friendship influence this achievement might not have been possible. Thank you. I'm proud to yet again immortalize our great family name. But most importantly, this building is for all the people of Dubai, which is today the tallest building in the world. So, I'm humbly proud to open the Burj Al Ghazali. Hello. Oh, my.
the scepter. Now please, be my guests and celebrate. And thank you.
They could just be his back.
Listen. I want to talk to the partners directly. Make them understand why all of this is happening. And that terminal gives me an idea. There's a server room near the Sheikh's personal reception. If you can gain access to it, we might be able to recover useful intel from it. We'll have to work together to hack the system, but it's our best shot. Looks like the staff area could provide you with a viable route to the server room.
Guess when the next one will
come. Not bad. Not bad at all.
There's a keypad lock on the doors to the staff area. One moment. All right, try this. 4706. There's quite a bit of security here. One moment. You ready for some more fresh air, 47?
Thank you.
Look, this is gonna make me look really bad.
I'm sure it's around here somewhere. Don't you worry. A colleague is also out there looking.
But this is awful. I mean, I'm in my boxers and you are a woman. It's just so embarrassing.
Oh, it's nothing I haven't seen before.
But you don't understand. I'm military. We military men are used to punctuality. I was supposed to be ready and present my papers half an hour ago.
Yes, you men in the army with your papers. Super punctual. I get it. Yeah.
Are you making fun of me? That's so cruel. Do you know what a man is without his gun?
Man in his boxers. Crying like a baby.
Ugh. You women will never understand.
And I don't think we ever will. Can't find it. Can't you just wear a waiter uniform? It would be pretty effective if you wanted to blend in.
What? Are you trying to be my mother? My God, no! I need to dress professionally and show my papers. Do you not understand that?
Okay, I'll keep looking.
Thank you. Somewhere else. I mean, you haven't found it yet.
I'm still looking.
I'm gonna be the laughing stock. And on my first day.
I think I can open that window remotely. Scan the lock with your camera and I'll have a try.
whatever.
Sheikh Al-Ghazali is reaching out to his worldwide network of lawyers and financial contacts, attempting to restore the lost power base of the Providence Partners. If Ingram and Stuyvesant were asked to a meeting, thinking they'll be told of new developments, I suspect they'd jump at the chance. There's a lounge area at the top of the building. It can be sealed off for private conversations. If we lure the targets there, they'll be trapped.
I must go and get the, from the oh, what did I say? I can't remember what it was. What's that? Oh, yeah. I'll get an hour, but I'll do it when I get to the, last night of the thing, and then I can get some, of the other stuff. Oh, God, it's yeah. Thank you.
calendar function. We can use this to summon the partners to a fake meeting, 47. All right, I'm no hacker like Olivia, but I think you need to pull one of the racks here to gain access to the terminal. Silent alarm has been tripped. Security is on its way. Hide, 47.
This is a restricted area, Nash. Show me your hands. Oi! Alpha team, there's a killer on the run. Riptide is hit.
Seven reinforcements are incoming. More guards on their way.
Watch your six, gentlemen. We got a casualty. Stay frosty.
Red Leader, one actual here. Got one naked male individual here.
Forty-seven, guards are heading your way. Be careful. Yes, sorry about that, 47. Let's try again, shall we? Ah, I think I've got it. We'll need a key card to gain access. Someone in maintenance should have one we can borrow for a spell.
Yes. Hello, sir.
Must have done something. Can you see anything different in the room? Guards are heading your way. Be careful.
Pick up.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Thank you.
Are you kidding me? No, it needs to simmer for perfection. It must not be disturbed. You speed it up and you break all the glorious flavors. It'll become mush.
Well, I got a call from upstairs that the guest is hungry.
When that clock rings, Mr. Ingram can eat and it'll be like the angels touched his palate. Heavenly. You understand?
But isn't it just a stew?
Oh, get out of my kitchen, you imbecile. I don't want your filthy words contaminating my food.
Idiot.
So, for your soup, make sure you have bones in the pot too. Not just meat, or else the stock really doesn't taste of anything.
See, that's what I thought I should do. But then I found this recipe.
Not with all in the
Anderson. My sound.
not to be taken for granted, where many have failed. During the course of history, we have been able to maintain our power since Providence was established.
But I like listening to the radio. Our Royal Highness has never complained about it before.
I'm sorry, but Mr. Ingram, who is the Royal Highness's guest, has requested no noise of any kind.
Okay, but it means I'll work slower.
I don't care what tempo you work.
It will be slow, and I'll probably get a warning about that.
What did you do?
I kicked his door in, put a gun in his face, told him if he didn't like noise, he could pack his shit, move out to the desert.
That was a bit brutal. Did he move?
Nah, he's my brother-in-law. My wife persuaded him to stay. He hasn't complained since.
Sounds cozy.
Hello, sir.
attendant! Hold on a minute! Oh, crap!
Hello.